kids, and welcome to VeggieTales. I'm Bob the Tomato.
And I'm Junior Asparagus.
And we're here to answer your questions.
Yep, that's right.
Junior!
Yes, Bob?
Your tooth
is back.
I don't get ya.
Maybe I should just show you.
Hey, QWERTY!
QWERTY!
Oh, come on!
QWERTY!
Will you stop that?
Oh, my!
Oh, my is right! Have I ever told you about the Israelites?
The Israelites. Oh, yeah, I remember those guys. Weren't they supposed to be God's chosen people?
Yes!
Oh, I bet they always followed God's directions.
Ho, ho, ho! You'd think so, wouldn't you?
What?
Close your eyes, Junior, and don't open them until I say so.
All right!
Okay. We're using our imagination.
Oh. So these must be the Israelites.
Yep.
Why are they out here in the middle of nowhere?
Oh, now that is a good question. Have you ever heard of a guy named Moses?
Huh? Isn't he the one who parted the Red Sea?
Right again! But we're gonna go back a little further. No.
What?
No, that's not it either. Ah, yes! That is the point. The Israelites were living in Egypt, but not because the Egyptians had taken them captive. No, but then the Egyptians were making them work very hard as their slaves. You're not going to enjoy this.
Buddy, you're a boy, make a big noise, playing in the street, gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place, singing,
We will rock you. We will rock you.
Yeah.
It was miserable, but God cared about the Israelites. So he sent Moses to lead them out of Egypt and into their own land, the Promised Land. Oh, the land God promised them was wonderful. You could grow things and there was lots of food. When Moses and the Israelites left Egypt, all they had to do was follow God's directions and they'd go right to the Promised Land. But they didn't always follow God's directions. Sometimes they went their own way instead.
Maybe we should have listened to God on this one.
Now, God was very disappointed in the Israelites for not following his directions, so he told them that none of them could go into the Promised Land for 40 years. By the time 40 years had gone by, Moses had died.
Wow.
That's why they're stuck here in the desert. Except Joshua.
Huh?
He was Moses' helper. And because Joshua believed in God, he could go into the promised land for years.
Through the forest, scooping up the goonies. And I can't stop myself.
Well, you're kidding me.
No. Kind of. When Moses died, Joshua became Israel's new leader. The Israelites were very sad about Moses dying because he was a great leader. But at last, it was finally time. So off they went. With a big grin, Joshua led his people into the promised land. He overlooked one little detail. Jericho.
Someone has bumped our wall.
I am Joshua. And these are the children of Israel. God has given us this land for our new home. So, well, you're gonna have to leave.
Because if anyone is to be doing the leaving, it will be you.
No, you don't understand.
You are just a baby gherkin.
I'm a
Let
cucumber.
Let me point something out to you. You have a wall.
Did you hear that, Jean-Claude?
Eh oui, Philippe.
Now listen to me. Our God said that this land was ours, and that all we had to do was follow his directions. So, I'm afraid, if you don't come out, we're gonna have to come in there after you.
It's showtime!
Uh-oh.
Maybe we should fall back and regroup. Oh, cheese in the crust. Things weren't going as smoothly as Joshua had hoped, so the Israelites decided to pull back and talk things over.
That's a big wall.
This time, I really mean it. We should go back to Egypt.
Oh.
Snorkeling in the Nile. 3 square meals a day, plenty of exercise. Oh, it was paradise.
We were in slavery.
Nothing is perfect.
You think he saw me?
Nope. I'll be right back.
Star.
That's right, and the moon, and even the earth that we're living on right now.
Wow.
Are you for us or for our enemies?
Neither, but as command. None of the army of the Lord, I have now come. Well, Josh fell face down on the ground. The Lord says to you, Joshua, see, I have delivered Jericho into your hands. March around the city once with all your men. Do this each day for 6 days. Have 7 priests carry trumpets of ram's horns in front of the ark. On the 7th day, march around the city 7 times with the priests blowing the trumpets. When you hear them sound a long blast, have all the people give a loud shout, and the walls of the city will collapse, and Jericho will be yours.
Oh, thanks. I think we're forgetting something. Ahem.
This is terrible!
That's kind of disgusting.
It wasn't long before the people of Jericho hit him with everything they had.
Keep walking, but you will knock down our wall. Keep walking, but she isn't gonna fall. It's plain to see, your brains are very small. To think walking will be knocking down our wall. Keep walking, but you will knock down our wall. Keep walking, but she isn't gonna fall. It's plain to see, your brains are very small. To think working will be knocking down our walls.
Double time!
Fire up the Womanator, Jerry!
Knew it!
Oh, no.
Well,
very disappointed. I am appalled.
Oh, that cracks me up! Well, that's just terrible.